Hey Premiere Pros, it's Paul Murphy here, and today I'm going to show you how to automatically edit long interviews, switching between different cameras using Timebolt. And if you don't have Timebolt, stick around because I've got two lifetime subscriptions to give away. Okay, so I have an interview on my timeline here that I've turned into a split screen. So I'm looking at both the host and the guest at the same time. And what I want to do is turn my interview into something like this, where when the guest answers a question, we cut to a full screen shot of the guest. The reason I want to do that is if there's anything I want to cut out of this interview, I can hide it when I cut to the full screen. And take a look at this. If I look at the waveform in my timeline here, you'll see that the places where I want to cut to the split screen of the host and the guest are pretty obvious. That's when the host is speaking. And then when the guest is speaking, it makes sense to cut to the full screen of the guest. So I can see that just by looking at the waveform. But here's the thing, this is a 45-minute interview, and I don't have the time to go through and manually make all of those cuts, which is why I use Timebolt to automatically detect when the host or the guest is speaking and make those cuts for me. And if you haven't used Timebolt before, it's actually an app that I use every single day, and it does something very simple. All it does is analyze a video and extract out these silent moments. And I have a video on how to do that in more detail here. But we can also use it to detect those silent moments and switch between cameras. Oh, and if you don't have Timebolt, we have two lifetime subscriptions to give away. And all you need to do is add a comment below this video and then click the link in the description to go into the draw for the giveaway. That's a lifetime subscription. That means that you could be using Timebolt up until the day you die. Imagine all the time you would save. Okay, so let's get started. Before we begin, we will need to download the free Timebolt plugin for Premiere. And then what we want to do is export out the host's audio. So I'm going to click solo on the host track, and then I'm going to go up to my export tab. And down here where it says format, I'm going to set this to waveform audio, and I'll call this host. Okay, and then let's jump over to Timebolt. I'm going to choose select audio or video file, and I'll choose that host audio that we've just exported out. And it's automatically detected what is the audio that we want to keep, which is the green, and what is the audio that we want to remove, which is the red. So that's anything that it considers to be silence. And with these silence detection options down here, I just want to make a few changes. So first we have the filter below sound level, and that means everything below this level is what it considers to be silence. And I really want to push this number as high as possible while keeping as much of the host's voice as possible. So I'm going to set this to -20 dB. The other two settings I want to change here are the remove silences longer than and ignore detections shorter than. So the way to think of that in the context of what we're trying to do is if the host goes quiet for longer than a specific time, that's a good indication that the guest is answering a question, and that's a good indication that we should be cutting away to the guest. So I'm going to set this to 5 seconds. And then we have ignore detections shorter than. The way to think of this is if the host is making any kind of sounds like aha, or a cough, or or something like that, that's not a reason to be cutting back to the host.
It's going
to
be a big concert at Adlai Stevenson Park.
And then I'll just make a few small changes to the padding down here. The padding is just adding a little bit more silence back to the left and right side of the audio. I'm going to set this to 0.1 of a second for the left padding, and then 0.5 or half a second for the right padding. And that just makes the cut seem a little bit more natural, especially since people at the end of their sentences tend to trail off a little bit. It just adds a little bit more space at the end of their sentence. And then I'll click update silence detection. And then if we have a look at the updated waveform here, it's actually looking pretty good. I can play through this, and I should only be hearing the sound of the host asking questions.
Unique things that you've come across really in your travels. Great. So let's start off.
And I'm going to use the up arrow key to just jump through the different sections where the host is talking.
Awesome. Yeah, I think that's really...
Okay, so that's sounding pretty good to me. And what I really like about this is if I look in there, it is ignoring some of the softer sounds and also some of the mm-hmms and the ahas.
You're not really listening to me, are you? I mean, I could say anything right now, like you're a complete tool.
So I think that's done a pretty good job. Now I'm going to go over here and click Save Timeline Cuts. And that's going to save a .json file next to the audio file that we rendered out of Premiere Pro. Now we're all done in Timebolt, I'm going to jump back over to Premiere Pro and I'm going to unsolo the host track. Now there's a couple of things that I want to do before we start applying those cuts. And first of all, I want to lock down all of my audio. So I'm going to hold down the shift key and click any of the locks in the audio tracks to lock all of our audio there. And then what I want to do is select all of my video clips. I'm going to go up and choose edit, select all. And then I'm going to put all of those video clips into their own sequence. So I'm going to right click and choose nest. And I'm going to call this Multicam. Now let's apply those cuts to that nested sequence. So I'm going to select it in my timeline. I'm going to go up to the Timebolt extension up here. And the first thing I want to make sure that I do is I click create cuts, but don't delete. So I don't want it to delete any silence. I just want it to show me where that silence is. And then I'll choose apply JSON file. And I'll click that file that I just saved out of Timebolt and choose open. And there you go. In seconds, it's applied all of those cuts to our timeline. And like I said, this is a 45-minute timeline. It's just done it like that. But there are still a couple of steps that we need to do here. First of all, it's added this empty audio track down here. I'm just going to right-click this and choose delete track. And then I want to select all of my video clips. So I'll go back up here and choose edit, select all. I'm going to right-click any one of these clips and I'm going to choose multi-camera enable. And what that means is I've turned that nested sequence into a multi-camera sequence. So now I can switch between the different tracks inside of that sequence. And at the moment, all of these tracks are just track one, which is why we're only seeing the split screen at the moment. But if I deselect everything, and then I'm just going to select any one of these red clips, I'm going to right click and choose label, select label group. So it's now selected all of the red clips in my sequence. And then I'll right click it one more time and choose multi-camera, go to camera two instead of camera one. And now wherever those red clips are, it's going to cut to the full screen of the guest answering the question. So let's have a quick look to see how this sounds.
Yeah, just some unique things that you've come across really in your travels.
Yeah, that sounds awesome. Keen to talk about that with you.
Which continents have you covered?
Okay, let's see. Yeah.
So you were in Sydney when the lockdown was happening?
Yeah, so I...
Great, so I think it's done a really good job of automatically switching between those cameras. And of course, now that we have that, we have the ability to go in and start making edits to this timeline as well without it being noticeable. So for example, we have a bit of silence here. All I need to do is make a cut there and you won't notice that I've taken that silence out.
Really in your travels.
Yeah, that sounds awesome.
So you're welcome to do that manually, or you could just run the whole thing through Timebolt again and get it to automatically take out those silent moments for you. And that's it. That's how you use Timebolt to automatically switch between cameras. If you're interested in purchasing Timebolt, I do have a link in the description below. But don't forget, you can also enter into the draw for a lifetime subscription. I hope this video has been helpful in your workflow. And until next time, thanks for watching.